Hello everyone, we're here in a fancy fancy restaurant, a large grill, but I'm here with a fancy fancy chef, Italian chef. I'm here with the chef Eliano Camboni, and he's going to talk about a lot of things that happened to him. He's going to talk about food, and he's going to talk about his visit in Israel in 81. What happened in 81 in Israel?
Well, in 81, at the time I was working for Princess Cruise, and I was docked on Haifa. And that is when the Achille Lauro hijackings happened. So the company canceled all the cruises and sent them home. that is the last time that I was in Israel. But like I was explaining, Sharon, my mom, you know, visit very often, and actually was there about a year ago. So I wish I can, you know, visit with her, but it's kind of far away from me. I went the closest to Israel was 3 years ago. I just visited Turkey and Greece. That was the most close countries that I visited in the last 2 years in the area. But now we're gonna talk about some Italian dishes, right?
Yes. Okay. So how do you say hi in Italian? Ciao?
We say ciao. We say ciao bella.
Ciao. Oh, thank you. Grazie. How do you say thank you in Italian?
Grazie.
Grazie. Grazie bella.
So we're gonna talk about a very old dish from North Italy, which is called casuncei. Casuncei is similar to a raviolo, except it's not square, but it's shaped like a candy practically. And there is usually stuffed with vegetables, but can also be stuffed with meats. So we're gonna talk about a casuncei with pumpkin. And this one is a roasted pumpkin. And in this case, we're gonna use a summer squash. Summer squash and onions blended together, and amaretto cookies. Amaretto cookies is a cookie that is available, you know, in most Italian groceries, and that will give a sort of like a bittersweet flavor and also enhance the flavor of the pumpkin. The pasta is shaped like a little candy, so twist at both extremes, put it on a plate, dusted with parmigiano and poppy seeds. And the sauce will be sage leaves, browned with brown butter. That will be the sauce. Very, very simple, but the crispy of the sage, the brown butter, it give a beautiful, beautiful flavor to this very ancient dish. And this is one of the dishes that I like to talk. And the next one will be with the ortica.
Ortica, which means with sirpad in Hebrew.
The sirpad is a plant that is typical of the Mediterranean. It's very popular in Italy because, you know, the healthy, for healthy reason, but it's also one of the so-called poor people food. And usually it's then fleshy saute with a little garlic, a little crushed pepper, and red pepper flakes, little garlic, little olive oil, what's his name?
Sirpad.
The sirpad, and some pasta of your choice, usually like spaghetti, penne, and it's very great flavor. It's sort of like an aglio olio with the ortica, and it's very mild. Sometimes I prefer that to spinach, you know, it's way better. Also, we use the same on frittelle, which is the sirpad with eggs, and make a little cake. There's another use of this particular egg.
So I wanted to ask you, we always dream about going to Italy. Let's talk about wine. And then we're gonna talk, after that, we're gonna talk about the restaurant that you have here in Los Angeles. But let's talk about wine for a very romantic, fancy dinner.
A wine to be ordered in a restaurant?
Yes.
Okay, so let's use it then. I mean, Italian wines, they are not pretentious. You know, Italian wines, they are like, an average for the average person. So they are like, a nice Pinot Grigio if you like white. Nice Pinot Grigio, usually the most popular is the Santa Margherita or the Zenato. Santa Margherita is a dry, very pleasant wine that is very, very popular and pleases lots and lots of people. Then, if you like red, one of my favorite is the Barolo. The Barolo is at the same level of the big French wines, except, you know, it's more affordable. So you're getting a really high quality red wine, very mild, very pleasant, easy to drink, that can be associated with any meat, any red meat, without spending, you know, the same amount of money that you spend for a big French wine. And that is gonna make your dinner very, very romantic.
You know, I have a dream to go to Tuscany and sit in the middle of a winery place with a little villa and just take a few drink wine.
For example, in Fucecchio, outside Firenze, you know, there is a lot of very nice, charming hotels. But now in Italy, it's very popular, the so-called agrotourism. Agrotourism is very popular because you are really in contact with the life of the Italian farmers. You're eating the same food they're eating, you're drinking the wine that they're being made on the factory. And that is a very good idea to how to properly, you know, introduce yourself to Italian and Italian life. It's not the same like, you know, staying in a hotel. So it's more close to the Italian life and Italian people. Oh, okay, Robert Levenstein was married with the Secretary of State of California, which was Kathleen Connor, and now is retired and he lives in Costa Rica. Okay, so which one should we show?
Okay, yeah,
this one, the creative choice.
Let's turn it around this way. Oh no, just leave it in there.
Yeah, leave it in. The restaurant that you opened in Los Angeles.
Yes.
Tell me about it.
Okay, we start with Basilico. Basilico was a restaurant. Basilico was this one. The first one. Basilico was a restaurant near Ronald Reagan Library, and jokingly, because I don't know that if the two men was kidding me or what, so I said to them, what did they say in my front? A bank? Because, you know, opening a restaurant, it requires large capitals.
But mention Danny DeVito, you mentioned Danny DeVito.
Yes, yes. What's happened was that day, on the patio area of the restaurant, there was Danny DeVito and his wife, which they was asking one of the waiters about a particular Italian dish called orecchiette, which is a little hot-shaped pasta with broccoli rub. So the waiter, because he doesn't know what Danny DeVito was asking, come in the kitchen and ask me. So I went outside and I told Mr. DeVito that give me 30 minutes, I will go to the Gelson, which was down Beverly Glen, Van Nuys, and I will go and buy that particular vegetable and make that particular dish. So I rush in my car, go to Gelson, get all the ingredients, and when I come back, say 40 minutes, the dish was ready and I prepared it. When I go back outside, these two gentlemen, they were sitting near the table, they approach me, and that is when they ask me if I want to open a restaurant. I do not take seriously, but they handed me a business card. So the following day, my time off between lunch and dinner in the afternoon, I went to the office of the Roberts Group, which the president was Robert Levenstein, and then I realized that it was very, very serious, and in a couple of days they drive me to Simi Valley area, where there was this beautiful shopping center in Country Club Drive, and that's how I start my restaurant. I don't put a penny, and end up with a 200 seating capacity restaurant. With Jacob,
we meet and I design a menu, which is a very beautiful menu, which is not using right now. but my concept of a glad kosher restaurant is like almost like the, I should say, the travels of the Jewish people all over the world. So in this menu is some sort of like an assemblage style menu.
Fusion.
Exactly.
What they like to call it today.
Yes.
But I wanted to ask you, what's your favorite? Which favorite are you going to be proud in? And
well, I like, for example, this one, which is a pan roasted breast of chicken with orange and fennel marmalade. And this one has some Indonesian flavors, and the fennel, which is Mediterranean. So it fuses, you know, Indonesian and Mediterranean.
So what's the second dish that you like?
Oh, I like that. You know, when you are asking about which is my favorite dish, it's like asking a father which is his favorite child.
This is not what I'm about to say. What's your favorite child?
So there is no one dish that is my favorite.
Okay, let's talk about one fish, one chicken, and one red meat.
One fish. Be extremely fresh, so he cannot be put on the menu, because when he's on a menu of fish, you are depending on you have to have the fish, so it's not really fresh. So fish for me has to be on special. It has to be an addition. You have to be free to serve the best fresh fish you have available. So the most that I can put as a fish has to be something that is readily available all the time. And in this case, I put a salmon, and and that's it, because salmon is readily available at any given moment. And the salmon that I put, actually I put two styles. One with a cedar plank, which is a piece of wood, and the fish is wrapped on the wood and roasted. So the cedar gives an aromatic flavor. And we serve this one with some sort of like a strawberry tomato keka, which is a sauce made with a diced tomato, garlic, basil, and something sweet, and also acidic, like a strawberry, so give a gastric. And that is the only fish. As a chicken, I serve a classic fish, a classic chicken, which is the rouladen. The rouladen is a breast of chicken stuffed, in this case, with mushroom. And this one served with a melange of different mushrooms. Then as a meat, I like it all, I'll be honest with you. I like all the meat that we serve. I like, for example, the ribeye. I like the Argentinian smoked short ribs. The Argentinian smoked short ribs, we serve this one with Jack Daniel sauce, which is a reduced whiskey, because Jack Daniel's, when you reduce it, you increase the sweetness of the whiskey.
Ooh.
And this one is served with molasses, tied together and brushed on.
Sounds good.
Yes,
a lot of
very,
vitamins,
very good.
B12.
and this one is just brushed on the smoked ribs until caramelized. So it's a very beautiful way to serve a short ribs.
There is no way it's gonna get wrong, this dish.
Not at all, but I like it all. I also like the lamb chop with
African lamb, I see.
Yes, this one is served with a mint sauce and tzatziki marmalade. So, you know, like I said before, it is a menu that really, really showed the entire world, actually, you know, all the. Everything from Mediterranean, European, Africa, North Africa, South America, Central America, everything.
Thank you, Chef Eliano Comboni. Yeah, I did it right.
Yes, perfect. You say perfect.
Thank you for this interview.
Oh, you're welcome, Sharon. And thank you very much. It was my pleasure. And again, thank you. Thank you
next
very much.
Next fancy dinner that I'm going to have with you. Hollywood actors and a Hollywood celebrity, I'm going to invite you. Either you like it or either you're not, you're going to make some beautiful dishes for us.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Thank you for this interview.
Thank you.